Welcome to the News 4 sponsored site, soundoffsouth.com. Here you can find links to all kinds of blogs from around the Carolinas. Each week we select a spotlight blog and feature it here on News 4 Today. This week's spotlight blog is Spartanburg Creative Energy, and Amanda Ingram is here to tell us more about the blog. Amanda, welcome.
Thank you.
Tell me, first of all, Spartanburg Creative Energy, it is a project of the city of Spartanburg. What is the blog about?
The purpose of the blog is to let our public know what's going on in Spartanburg, downtown and within the county. And so we have all the upcoming events, all creative events that are going on with nonprofits. The event that you just saw is a lunch and learn at the Spartanburg County Library held tomorrow. We've also posted video of Art Cycle, which is a creative project that we've done downtown. So it's just a constant alerting of what's going on and to reach that unique target market that reads blogs, that follows Facebook, that follows Twitter. That's what our purpose was with the blog.
And really to give folks an idea, not just maybe in Spartanburg, but also throughout the upstate, mm-hmm. what Spartanburg has to offer by way of entertainment.
Oh yes, we have several readers from all over the country when we followed from DC to California to New York. So it's not just the Spartanburg area. Our main readers come from Greenville and Spartanburg and Asheville.
Well, one of the events I want to talk about is we have a picture of the Lunch Jazz event. Mm-hmm. I think we can show that in just a second if they can call that up. There it is. Tell us about that. Is that a weekly, monthly event? How often does that happen?
That occurs every Friday. The Lunch Jazz was the first two Fridays of April, but now we have Jazz on the Square, which starts at 5:30 every Friday night in downtown Spartanburg. It's fabulous. You come in with your family, have a great time, see some public art, and then you can enjoy any of our downtown restaurants afterwards. So it's very family friendly. Bring a picnic if you'd like. So it's a great event.
Okay. Well, I wanted to ask you, what would you say is Spartanburg's top, or are Spartanburg's top three or four cultural venues?
We have Hubbub, which is excellent. It's mainly free, or their average ticket price is $10. We have the Spartanburg Memorial Auditorium that brings in those big name groups. We also have the Chapman Cultural Center, which is this excellent new facility if you have the time to go out and visit. Completely free right now to see all the exhibits, but then you also have the David Reed Theater, which brings in Groucho, which is coming up on Tuesday. We also have the Twitchell Auditorium, which is where our ballet Spartanburg performs. So there are different venues throughout downtown, all within a good 10-minute driving distance from each other, so it's fabulous.
And the latest thing, you mentioned it just a few minutes ago, is Art Cycle. You guys mm-hmm. kicked it off this past week. Tell us about Art Cycle.
Art Cycle is a great partnership between taking recycled bicycle parts and celebrating our Bicycle Month. Spartanburg is one of the first bicycle-friendly communities in the Southeast. And what we did was we offered the opportunity for artists to take the bicycle parts and make it their own.
And we're showing right now one of the artists' work there. I guess this mm-hmm. is the work in progress.
It is. This is Soul Train, Hub City, South Carolina, by artist Lauren Ponder out of Spartanburg, South Carolina. Our artist came from all over, from Asheville. We have a representative from Presbyterian College. We have three high school students that worked on a piece, and they're downtown. And the neat thing is that we're progressive, and we did a cell phone map. So you can call in, learn more about the artist, and you know, travel through downtown and have a great walk. At the same time.
Amanda, thank you so much for being here.
Thank you so
much. I do want to say, in our next half hour, you're going to meet a stay-at-home mom from Spartanburg who loves the city and who volunteers to help get the word out about arts in Spartanburg. She'll tell you why blogging is a must when it comes to getting younger generations involved in Spartanburg's art scene.